Hey guys, let's take a look at these ruins called Malige Medu, located in the small village of Gangaikonda Cholapuram. This was one of the royal palaces of Rajendra Chola, the greatest Indian king who lived in the 11th century. To call Rajendra Chola the greatest king of India is actually an understatement, because he conquered a much larger area which now spans to more than 10 different countries, including Malaysia, Maldives, Indonesia, and Bangladesh, and countries like Cambodia and Thailand were also under his rule because they were paying taxes and tribute to him. So he should be ranked as one of the greatest kings in the world. This was one of the royal palaces that he built. It is surprisingly small, and we don't know exactly how he used this building. While the Chola kings used granite to build great temples, they used bricks for their houses. These bricks that you see are 1,000 years old, and you can see how perfectly they're baked and aligned, just like modern day houses. This is also one of the reasons why palaces and houses of Cholas don't exist today. Since their houses were built with bricks, they could be easily destroyed by kings who came at a later time, and local people have also destroyed them by taking them apart for their own construction. My measurements show some intriguing details. These walls are about 53 inches thick. Now, why would a brick wall in a palace need to be 4.5 feet thick? We are talking 10th century, where there was no form of artillery, so it was definitely not for defense. The only logical reason for such thick walls is to support the weight of more floors on the top. This is confirmed by the fact that several granite pillar bases with circular holes are found on this site. Pillars like these would have been placed on top of them, and you can even see the outer square where the pillar once stood. Is it possible that the Cholas built multi-story buildings 1,000 years ago? So I started to research if Cholas ever mentioned multi-story buildings in their copper plates or stone inscriptions, and also talked to the locals if they knew something of the sorts. I found out two interesting things. What we see here is not the ground level, but the second or third floor of the palace. The ground level is roughly 60 feet deep. Locals told me that they find all sorts of granite and brick structures as deep as 60 feet in this village whenever they dig foundations for their houses or dig water wells. Believe it or not, what seems to be a small village today called Gangaikonda Cholapuram was the capital of the massive Chola Empire 1,000 years ago. It turns out that some major natural calamity happened and the entire city lays buried under the ground. So what we see here is actually the second or the third floor of the building. Secondly, there are multiple writings and stone tablets that point out that this was a multi-storied building. The inscriptions clearly mention multiple levels of the royal palaces of the Chola kings. Now imagine this being the third floor, which is built with a wall thickness of 4.5 feet. It was constructed to easily support another 5 floors. This means that Rajendra Chola had an 8-story palace, like a modern day apartment complex, or it could have been a pyramidal structure like the Thanjavur Palace built in the 17th century. This also shows that the whole concept of going vertical instead of taking up a large space on the ground was not something that's recently invented, but something that existed 1,000 years ago. After the catastrophe, half of this palace would have buried, while the remaining half would have stood above the ground level. The kings who came afterwards destroyed what's above the ground. Another intriguing detail is that archaeologists found several Chinese potsherds here. This is truly fascinating because historians argue that the world was not connected until a few hundred years ago. But Rajendra Chola and his father Rajaraja had international connections around the world. While these patchworks prove Chinese connection, a year ago I showed you a sculpture which proves that the Cholas were in contact with the French, so they covered both East and West 1,000 years ago. I'm Praveen Mohan. I hope you like this video. Thanks a lot for watching. Please do subscribe and I'll talk to you soon.